So last session, we rounded out our exploration of foods to eat, to feel and stay satisfied without loading up additional calories with a discussion on low-density foods. You were challenged to remove the majority of processed foods from your diet for 2 weeks and focus on protein and low-calorie dense foods. So how did it go? Did you find the combination of protein and low-calorie dense foods curbed your appetite? Did you feel you were getting enough food? Did you achieve the goals that were set in your treatment plan for important nutrients like protein? We would love to know if you found it helpful or if you had any problems. So let's start by completing this sentence. I eat when I'm, and you put the word in that best describes why you eat when you do. The obvious answer is hungry. I eat when I'm hungry. Are you sure you're hungry? It may seem like an odd question, but it is actually quite easy to interpret some other uncomfortable feeling as hunger. For example, when you're watching a movie and you start to feel hungry and need to grab a bowl of popcorn even though you just ate lunch. Other situations, like time of the day to eat, like it's breakfast, I gotta eat my breakfast. Lunchtime, I gotta eat my lunch. And dinner, I have to eat my dinner. It's time specific. Or when you're bored, or say you're stressed out from work, you had an argument with your boss or a family member, and guess what? You wanna curl up and have a nice pint of ice cream. Many of us have parents who want us to eat everything on your plate. You know, don't get up unless your plate is completely empty. They were unhappy if you left food on your plate and happy if you ate everything. So these are all habits that you've learned and you've learned throughout your life. And these are things that push you to continue to eat even despite not being hungry. So pretty soon, if you didn't finish your plate, you learned to worry more about pleasing your parents than you did about eating when you were hungry and stopped when you were satisfied. So in essence, the act of eating may not truly be directed by actual hunger, but by emotional or conditional reasons. Then you moved into adulthood and eating became a social affair. You drank to please your friends, you ate to please a host or hostess who may have cooked you a meal, or your friends, or because it's time to eat. So it is quite possible that for many years you have not allowed yourself to feel true hunger. What is true hunger? When we are hungry, your body responds by signaling the brain, which in turn creates sensations you interpret as hunger. Symptoms of true hunger are stomach growling, feeling of emptiness, having difficulty in concentrating because your blood sugars are going down. So in order to get a better sense of when to eat for hunger reasons versus for other reasons, it is important to listen to your body to see if you are truly hungry. How can you tell the difference? You have to pay attention to the sensations you get when you know you are not hungry. That's right, not hungry. For example, if you had just eaten a meal and you are satisfied, how do you feel? When you're not hungry, you don't feel empty inside, your stomach is not growling, and you're able to maintain your activities without difficulty, without fatigue, or difficulty in concentrating. So here is my challenge for the next 2 weeks. Each time you sit down to eat in the next 2 weeks, try this. Take a few deep breaths, close your eyes, concentrate on the hunger sensations in your body. Take notice of the intensity and location of the hunger sensations, and then decide if you're truly hungry or not. I'm not going to tell you not to eat if you're not really hungry or if you're unsure. The goal here is to get in tune with what you are feeling and recognize the difference between being hungry and just wanting to eat. For the moment, especially if you have had bariatric surgery, your sensations of hunger are all turned around anyway, so the priority in your case is keeping up with your nutrient recommendations. But later on, recognizing true hunger and delaying eating until you are hungry will be as important for you as it is now for those who are using medical weight loss to improve their health. Take notice of your body, and we will talk about your experience next session.